Hi, my name is William Goldsmith, author and illustrator of Mark Anchovy Pizza Detective, and I'm very happy to be reading to you for BookBound 2020. So, Mark Anchovy, what's it about? Well, it's about a boy called Colin Kingsley, who lives in a sleepy seaside town and works as a pizza delivery boy, but secretly he wishes he was a private detective. His life is turned upside down when he meets the Golden Spatula League, and they offer him his first detective case. He has to find a stolen painting while on a school trip to Rome. You can expect lots of danger, lots of gadgets, lots of ancient history, and of course, lots of pizza. So I'm going to read to you the opening section now. What I had in mind that summer was no homework and easy money. Instead, I ended up with a valuable stolen painting, various death threats, and more pizza than I could handle. Perhaps I should have just done a paper round or walked someone's Labrador, but I chose to be a private detective. It was my grandpa, G Pops, who started it. He sat there watching this grainy film starring some actor he called Bogey, who snooped after gangsters in a flappy cream coat. "He's like you, kiddo," he would rasp. "You're always so good at deducing things, like a detective." By things, he meant deducing that the plague puddle in his fridge was once a cucumber, or that his glasses hadn't been kidnapped, but were on his head, or that his monthly pills had been snaffled by Dinner Gloves, his dog, and that Dinner Gloves needed his stomach pumped ASAP. "My little detective," he would cackle. "My little bogey." This might sound like a weird thing to call your grandson, but I got the reference. For my birthday, he handed me a duffed up green and white paperback called The Big Sleep, something he was partial to. Inside the cover, alongside a library find from 1978, he had written, "For Colin, don't ever stop being a detective." After that, his words started pinballing around my head. I did like deducing things, spotting things, remembering things. The doctor once said my brain was like a film camera. What if I was a detective? I mean, yes, I was a pizza delivery boy. But couldn't I be both? A pizza detective? So I got told of a flappy cream coat. I made some laminated calling cards. I began snooping, not expecting much. After all, Rufflington-on-Sea isn't exactly a hotbed of crime. Someone might walk off with the post office barrow, or prank call the old phone box, or a badger might knock over your bins. But everything changed with one fishy password. Chapter 1. It began with three suspicious pizzas. We were in Caesar Pizza, an ancient Rome-themed pizzeria run by my parents, Cosmas and Irma Kingsley. Nice names, I know, but they went and called me Colin. Anyway, it was about 8 and we were waiting for the orders to come in. My dad was mopping up stray clouds of flour, grunting to himself. I was thinking about my school trip to Italy the next day, or trying to think, over the noise of my sister, Alicia, practicing her double bass upstairs. My mum babbled on the phone in her super polite, high-pitched voice. "Yes, yes, Connor can come round. Yes, yes." She wrote down the orders and gave them to me. "Is that my trench coat you're wearing, darling?" She knew it was. I just shrugged and didn't tell her that there was no point being a detective if you didn't have a trench coat. I read the orders. Major Marjorie, Buckdean Hall, Seabury Road. 1 7-inch Mark anchovy pizza, extra anchovies. Mr. Sterling Biggs, 40 Weeping Willow Way. 1 14-inch Mark anchovy pizza, extra anchovies. Patrick Moore, Hut 37, Shingle Row, 1 12-inch Mark Anchovy Pizza, extra anchovies. For most people, this would read like a fairly harmless list of pizzas. But if you looked closely, you would know that it was a cry for help. Extra anchovies, said my mum, adjusting my collar as I squirmed away. People are funny. I didn't think it was funny at all, because no one asks for extra anchovies, unless, that is, they had seen one of these. The cheesy, salty, fishy smell of cooked Mark Anchovy pizzas halted my train of thought. I packed the satchel and wheeled out my bike. My dad stood in the doorway. Be back by 9, he said. Go safely, darling, called my mum. Okay, I shouted before pedalling off. The sun was setting behind the oak trees, casting shadowy splashes on the bungalows. I picked up the pace as the tarmac blurred beneath me in a jerky flurry. I focused on my first port of call, Buckdean Hall. I'd only ever seen it from a distance, poking up from the cliff top like an elaborate tombstone. It used to be an all-girls boarding school, but we'd heard on the grapevine that someone lived there now. Who it was had been a mystery until now. Major Marjorie? What kind of a name was that? A sea mist hit my nostrils as I sped towards the railway arches. It was cool under there, like a cave. I looked around at the traffic lights and saw a lonely kebab shop. Its neon sign, bludgeoned by a moth, spelt King Skewer. Inside was a girl with big dark eyes, rolling up wraps at lightning speed. At the till stood a bulky man wearing a paper crown. Was this the king? He shouted to be heard over the din of the deep fat fryer. One more lamb shawarma. I watched the girl as her nimble fingers flew over the pickled chilies. A car horn honked behind me. Beep! Something banged against my handlebars and I capsized onto the pavement. A bus lurched past with an insulting toot. Then I saw the crime scene splattered on the curb. My satchel had gone flying, and the pizzas were everywhere. And I do mean everywhere. So that's the first part of Mark Anchovy, Pizza Detective. You might want to think about the following questions. Number one, what kind of town is Rufflington-on-Sea? What kind of person orders extra anchovies? And number three, how many seconds should you leave a slice of pizza on the floor for before eating it? You can find out more about Mark Anchovy at piccadillypress.co.uk. Thank you very much for watching and happy reading.